The Wendy Adams Show is for all seekers of truth and anyone who seeks to understand the many mysteries of our place in the cosmos and life itself. We explore a variety of topics that we feel are most urgent and valuable at this time, and strive to find real truth and solid answers through contemplating, sharing, and exploring experiences and understanding of the bigger picture. We live an incredibly exciting, new, and even awkward time in the history of our planet. History has been written and rewritten in so many ways, and truth hidden for so many reasons. It is a very real challenge to discern what is real and what is programmed in our society and lives. Together and through our mutual explorations and discussions, we have the ability to elevate our understanding and raise the frequency of our planet to a level that literally assists the evolution of humankind. There is so much we can do to make a difference for ourselves, our lives, and our future within the greater universal reality. Please join us in this journey of discovery. Evolve your truth. We are all here for a purpose. Let us discover what is within us and what we have yet to discover from without us. Welcome to Lightwaves Radio Show, The Wendy Adams Show. I'm just going to take a brief moment with you all before I invite on my guest today. There are many challenging things going on in the world. Hey, you guys are aware of that. You are living it every day. And awareness is definitely key. But the biggest message I have been receiving and is currently coming through is preparedness. Be prepared with your supplies, your food, water, anything that you need daily to get by. If you can, try to keep the drama out of your life or limit it. At this point, anyone or anything that doesn't bring peace, love, or happiness to your life really shouldn't be a part of your life. And that can be a hard pill to swallow. It could be people that you love. It could be family members. No matter what the case is, put yourself first at this time and only accept the love that you're giving out back in return. Nothing less than love is really what we're striving for at this point. There has been a massive wave of transparency in the universe. And the interesting thing is that previously we would have to expose others and kind of show their true colors. With this new wave of transparency, that's not necessary. They are exposing themselves. They're almost tripping to show you their true intentions. And it's wild. But you know what? Right now, if someone does show you their true colors, believe them. Believe them. You know, I recently posted a little meme on my Facebook page that stated, when someone shows you their true colors, don't try to repaint them. And that is a thing that many of us try to do. We try to look for the understanding and we create excuses for their behavior. Well, this isn't like them. This isn't this. Perhaps this is exactly what they are like and they haven't been showing us their true selves. Right now, what you're seeing is the truth. There are no masks anymore. And what they're putting out there is actually who they truly are, deep to their soul. And that's one of the things that's really difficult. And I get that. But definitely acceptance is the key. And we have to accept people where they are. But we don't have to bring them into where we are. That's a choice. And you can make that decision to do that or not to. But trust your intuition on that. See, healing is so important. And we cannot evolve higher without healing. That is one of the most important things that we can do, because self-love is essential to our growth. And with that in mind, if we're allowing others to treat us less than we deserve, then we're not loving ourselves. Love yourself every day. And really, really, at this point, put a boundary out there that only what you're putting out is allowed to come back to you. And that's really one of the things that we need to take into consideration. Like I said, things are challenging out there. There's so much going on in the world. And if we don't put a boundary up, and if we don't have a line set that people cannot cross, then we are consenting to whatever they're doing. So that's one of the biggest ways to say, hey, I do not consent, is to have a boundary and say, nothing less than I'm putting out is allowed to come back to me. And as I always say, make your words and your actions come from your heart center. And that is something that Rasa Priya does every day. So I'd like to go ahead and welcome him on at this time. How are you doing?
I'm doing really well. Had some physical challenges, but overall, I'm doing pretty good with it.
So I got to ask, how did you get started on your journey that led to the sound healing?
Well, it started when I was a child. When I was younger, I was experiencing abuse, and I used music as a place to go, a place to feel comforted, a place where I could express myself. I picked up the guitar and started learning to play classical guitar. So that was the first place where I felt I could actually really express myself without being abused, you know, without being belittled, hit, and those kind of things. And that was the first access that I had to music. And from a young age, I had many experiences. I guess I'll call them spiritual experiences. So I was very inquisitive from a young age regarding spirituality. I had some very esoteric experiences, and I never felt like I could actually really relate with people around me, the kids around me at school. I just felt so out of place and so out of touch. Even the adults. The adults seemed to focus on certain things that I just didn't really connect with in a deep way. Nothing really satisfied my heart, but music had that connection. For some reason, music seemed to really do that for me. It was beyond words. It was really just about a feeling, a deep feeling. And from that point in childhood, you know, I continued on with music into junior high, and I pursued many different kinds of instrumentations, and I got into listening to all kinds of rock bands and things like that. But the funny thing was, when I listened to those groups, I could never hear the words. I never, for some reason, I could not remember the words. And to this day, I can't sing lyrics to a song. But it was the vibration of the song. Like, I remember Led Zeppelin specifically. They really did it for me. And again, I didn't know the words, but the way that the music felt really touched my soul in a very deep way. That's how I started.
Wow. That's incredible. I'm so sorry that you had to go through all those experiences, but that's really truly what's, like you said, brought you on the journey to this. So a blessing that's come out of it.
Yeah, you know, I really think so. You know, I definitely feel that every part of that was a blessing. And at this stage of my life, I even see it as, I feel grateful for that experience. You know, it might sound silly, but I'm actually grateful that I was abused by that particular person. And the reason why is because I feel capable of healing that whole lineage. It can stop right here with me in my lifetime. So I feel that it was actually just simply perfect, you know?
It doesn't sound odd or silly, because when you're looking at it that way, it's what really truly gave you the stepping stones to elevate your experience and to bring you to this point where you can assist others. So there is something beautiful that's come out of it. And I love that you're acknowledging that. It's huge.
Yeah, I really feel that way.
Absolutely. One of the things that I wanted to ask you is, can you tell us a little bit about what you do and how it works?
Sure. So I do shamanic sound healing. And I play the crystal bowls, gongs, the traditional sound healing instruments, but I also incorporate sarod, tambura, mantras, chants, shamanic invocations. I bring in a lot of those elements, and my focus is not so much love and light, although that can be part of it. My focus is really about shadow work, going into those places that are not seen, really to help people become empowered on the things that they believe keep them stuck. You know, the filters, the mental filters, their conditioning.
That's important. A lot of people and, you know, the collective currently are really doing a lot of spiritual bypassing, saying that everything has to be love and light. And we don't grow or evolve unless we are exposed to trauma, pain. Things is what helps us elevate our soul and to get our vibration to be the highest. We can't really skip that. We don't heal if we skip it.
Yeah, I totally agree. And for me, it's really an integration process. Like, instead of cutting things out or eliminating this and all that, it's really integrating everything about who we are and all the potential energies out there that we also are part of. So it's really an inclusive type of perspective. And in the work that I do, that's what we do. We focus on really how can we include those shadowy aspects into our being. And I'll give you an example, okay? Jealousy, for instance, or anger. So sometimes in the spiritual community, you know, we might hear, oh, you know, we have to remove our anger. And my perspective is very different. It's like, no, let's honor our anger. Yes, anger can be used in either an effective way or ineffective, but, you know, to bypass and say, no, we're just going to remove anger, to me, that's not a real thing. So to really incorporate all those things, all of our experiences, all of who we are, and really be okay with that, that to me, that is self-love, you know? So that is my focus during these sessions, to really help people find who they naturally are, who they already are, and include all of their humanity. You know, instead of trying to think we have to become enlightened or something else other than we are, in this moment, you know, to really embrace your complete divinity in your humanness right now. And what I really want to share, because it's so beautiful, it's so powerful. You know, we don't have to wait to have perfect meditation and sit in silence without any thoughts. No, we can find our true spiritual essence as we are, no matter where we're situated right now.
I agree completely. And you're absolutely right. It really is about remembering who we are. It's not about learning. It's not about all that. It's about remembering what's already within us and who we are. And that's exactly what the experience is meant to be. So I love that.
Yeah, actually, it's funny that you say that, because that's, I had a very strange experience. I've been having, you know, over these last couple of weeks, Sarah, my wife, Sarah, she thought she was going to die. You know, we had to call an ambulance and deal with some physical things that way. I was telling you, I was going through some physical things. Well, a couple of days ago, my vision was impaired. I couldn't see. My voice was impaired. I lost the ability to walk, and I'm supposed to do sound healings in them. You know, so one might panic, but I didn't. I embrace everything that wants to come. It's like I know that underneath whatever is presented, there is something very substantial there. So getting back to my point, a couple weeks ago, I had an experience that was like a hallucinogenic experience. I was completely straight. No intoxication, nothing. But I went into this state, and I say hallucinogenics because as a teen, I had experimented looking for spirit in hallucinogenics. And I came across all these things, all these abilities that I could do. I could see auras. I could see, I had certain understandings. I knew about the Akashic, the field, and I didn't even know what to call it. I had a lot of powers and a lot of abilities. I always thought in the back of my mind, I wonder, is it the hallucinogenic? Maybe I was just hallucinating. Well, a couple weeks ago, I experienced that realm straight, and I realized exactly what you just said, already who I am. It was always who I was. You know, at the time with the hallucinogenics, I had filters and fear and all these things that impaired my vision. But a couple of weeks ago, I didn't have that. And it was extremely clear. There was absolutely no fear. And it was exactly what you just said. You know, it's who we naturally are.
You know, so many people have been over time, I hate to use the word program, but technically it's kind of what's happened. They've been told, this is who you are, this is what you are, this is what you're capable of doing.
Yes.
And once we throw all that aside and say, hey, and look, go within, that's when we find out really who we truly are. So definitely, like, and I can see that you've had those gifts and abilities all your life. And so it wasn't necessarily about escaping. It was about trying to reconnect to what you have within you.
Absolutely. And yes. And I believe that, you know, myself, I'm not more special than anyone else. You know, I really believe that each one of us has this and we can access this. But the thing that I see is most people, their conditioning, like you mentioned, gets in their way. The judgment of themselves, the need for external validation, all those things are like noise, you know? And if they just really embrace who they naturally, honestly are, including those shadowy aspects of themselves, they're going to just fall hopelessly in love and be, oh my God. This is huge.
Absolutely. You know? I love that. It's so true. And so many are willing to judge themselves or others and gosh, like embrace all that you are, even the dark traits, all of that things. It's all part of you. So many people are like, well, you can only be love and light. It's like, no, we all have the capability for everything. It's what we do with it matters.
Yes, yes. And that's such an important thing, what you just said there, you know, because some of those things, like when we look out into the world, you know, we might see the child molester. We might see the murderer or whatever thing that we judge as heinous. But those potentials are also us. Any one of us was put into a circumstance. We didn't have resources or people to help us through or the inside or whatever it was. We could end up expressing our wounding just like everyone else. And when we realize that, we're able to hold more space for everyone's expression of wounding. We can see, oh, they're wounded. They're expressing from pain. You know, that's why they're mean. That's why they're self-centered. That's why they're narcissistic or whatever it is, you know? And that awareness is just, to me, that is the how we heal the planet. It's how we hold space for one another, you know, to be tolerant with those misgivings.
Absolutely. I love that. You know, that's one of the things that so many people do is when they begin a relationship, you know, you have like that honeymoon phase and they accept everything. But then as soon as the person's locked in, they want to change everything. Like, I'm completely different on that. I'm like, you know what? You got to accept the person that you're with exactly as they are and encourage them to be themselves, not who you want them to be. Because we have too much of that going on out there. too, I believe.
We totally do. And we do that a lot to our children, you know. That's one thing Sarah and I are consciously trying to work at. And we're not perfect, you know. We make mistakes all the time, and we welcome our mistakes. It's okay. But we're trying to do that with our son, is just really get out of the way and let him emerge and show who he wants to be, not what we think he should be, even if it's, you know, in opposition to our values and beliefs or whatever. It's not really about satisfying us. It's him emerging as he wants to be fully.
Definitely. You know, speaking of sons, I remember when my son was quite young, he said to me, you know, Mommy, would you still love me if I was a murderer? And I said, wow. And I said, yeah, I would. Well, how could you? He asked me. And I said, because I said, I love you, the person. I said, it's your actions that I would hate, but I would still love you.
Yeah. Wow. That's powerful.
It was powerful. Such a, our children, they're coming and blowing us away with their gifts and their abilities. Like what kind of a question? I mean, I would never have ever anticipated being asked that, but I was glad he did, you know, ask me that question.
Yeah, that's amazing that you're able to hold that kind of space and reflect that back to him. I mean, you know, not everyone would have come to that conclusion. So that's pretty amazing that you can hold that kind of space.
Definitely. We need to start doing more of that, because you're right. When people are behaving in a certain way like that, they need some healing. They need some love. They need some understanding and some compassion. And we need to stop making it about ourselves on this journey, because this journey that we're on is not about us. It's rather for us. And that's where some people miss the boat. So when people are coming at you in a certain way, you have to separate their actions from their being, their essence, and really look at the bigger picture and see, how can I help? They're hurting. Obviously, if they're lashing out at me, it's nothing to do with me. How can we help them? And if we can get more people doing that, imagine the healing that we can inspire.
Yeah, no, I totally agree. That's really quite something.
I'm taking on a little bit of a tangent, but that's kind of what happens whenever I'm doing a radio show. So getting back to the sound healing part of it, what is a sound bath?
So a sound bath is basically same thing as a sound healing, is I create, either I or Sarah and I together, we'll create a soundscape. You know, we incorporate all the different things. We incorporate technology, knowledge with music, our artistry and creativity. And we create this soundscape that really allows the person to go on a journey. And it's very textured, very rich, and very specific also. I'll give you an example. Like, one of the elements that we bring in is North Indian classical music, which is designed to invoke emotion. Specifically, some of the other things, we have different realms. Like, we have the angelic realm. After some of the heavier sections, we bring the angelic realm in to really kind of give people a sense of peace and help them feel good. When we go into the darker realms with our sounds, it can really shake people up. You know, we've had people describe it and really like, oh my God, that just seemed like that was almost hell. And they said it was a good hell, but it seemed like that. You know, we've had a person in a community event run out and have to actually throw up, you know, purge. So it can be super heavy, and people say that when they go through our experience, they experience sensations, physical sensations, the kundalini up the spine. They see things, they see entities, they've seen their relatives. You know, it's really them. So we provide this soundscape that's very textured and very specific on our end, and then it allows them to have their own individual experience in relation to the soundscape that we create.
I love it. So it's really creating a true safe environment for them to, without any judgment or programming or conditioning, go within and to access themselves.
Yes, definitely. Definitely.
What kind of things or, you know, issues do people seek out sound therapy for?
Well, it's really varied. Okay. Sometimes we have people who are just very curious. They've never seen or been to a sound healing, and they just want to experience something new. Living here on Maui, a lot of people are wanting to experience a different kind of Maui spiritual experience. So we can provide that. I mean, we just show them themselves, basically. And then we have people that are after some serious processing work, like they have issues with something in them is driving them to be a certain way, maybe in their relationships. And it keeps coming up over and over and over again, and they're not sure why. So they're looking for, what is that core wound? What is that thing that makes me do what I do? So we provide that service as well. Sometimes it's about self-empowerment. You know, people are not being able to express their authentic truth because they're fear of judgment or something like that. And I think just a couple days ago, a woman came and her daughter had been killed about 6 weeks ago. And she had just been keeping herself busy. So she just needed that moment to really stop and really allow what was really happening for her in regards to her emotion. So that was very powerful for her.
Oh, absolutely. And that's one of the things that we as human beings here in this place need to do, is we need to process our grief. We need to feel it to heal it. And so many of us try to keep busy and run away from it, but it'll always catch up to you. So it's best to just stand and be with it and feel it.
You know, that is so true. And I think that's one of the most common themes is what you just mentioned. People are busy. They're so busy with their things they have to do, their tasks, their making a living, etc., their families, and everyone so preoccupied that they very rarely take time to sit with themselves in silence and just breathe. And when that happens, well, a couple things happen. Sometimes some people are very uncomfortable with that space. They feel agitated, they feel anxious, they feel antsy, they don't know why, it's just very uncomfortable, and there's something there for them, you know. They can go beyond that and sit with it. They're going to find something. But a lot of people don't take that time. I call it, that's how you do self-love. That's how you do self-care, is you give yourself that time. It nourishes your soul. It reveals so much.
Yeah, it definitely does. I love that. And I love the fact that the sound healing takes you to such a deeper state where you can actually have a real healing, because there's different levels. Can you talk about that?
Yes, for sure. So most of the time we're in a sympathetic nervous system state. You know, we're just doing our thing, trying to navigate. We're driving, so we have to make sure, you know, everything's just right there for us. All our senses are on track to keep us safe. And when we relax and we take a pause, when we lay down, when we breathe in silence, we go into a parasympathetic state. That's where all the healing takes place. Your body starts healing. Deeper than that, you can go into a theta state, you know, and the theta state, that's where so much information is revealed. That theta state is that place right before you're sleeping and you go off into your dream world and you're still awake. You might have like jerks or feeling like you're going to fall or something like that, but that's the theta state. So a lot of people, when they come to our sound healings, they get to experience these things. And it's almost as if it's the first time. It's really not, but it seems like that because they don't take that time for themselves and do it naturally. You know, so they come here, they give themselves that time, they experience that, and they find out so much about what's going on for them.
So if someone were wanting to have a session with you guys, how would they go about doing that?
Well, they would go to our website, MauiSoundHealing.com, and they can book a session. And we have different types. We have the sound healing, you know, we have private sound healings with either one person or, you know, just a few of them, whatever they want to do. And then I do shamanic sessions also. And those are a little bit more intense. They're one-on-one. They're designed for heavy stuff, heavy work, really going after some life-changing type of events. And then I also do some teaching to help others develop their own skill sets, their own ability to be creative, to be more intuitive, to be more in touch, really access their powers, I guess you might want to call it, you know, who they already are. So those are the things that I offer. And they can go to our website, as I mentioned. I also have a YouTube channel, a lot of free content. If they search Rasa Priya, P-R-I-Y-A, they can see my YouTube channel, and it has podcasts on there as well. So those are the various ways that people can connect with what I do and explore for themselves.
Wonderful. So now, you work with your wife a lot. We got to mention her, because she's a big part of this process too. Is that okay? We talk about what she does? Okay, absolutely.
Yeah.
Well, tell us about Sarah and what she does. I want to make sure she's acknowledged here.
Yeah, no, for sure. Sarah is definitely my partner. I mean, she does so much behind the scenes. She's actually a huge part of how this whole thing manifested. Just her ways and her vision and her support and who she is as a person. It's funny, when we met, we're such opposite types of people. You know, here I am, kind of like a hippie-ish kind of person, into spirituality, all that, art, you know, really creative and an artist. And she's quite the opposite, or she was quite the opposite. Very smart. She's Capricorn, very good at business. She's an ICU nurse. By the way, that's how we met in the hospital. We met in the hospital. She's a nurse and I was a respiratory therapist, and that's how we connect. But in saying that, her vision and her way of doing things, what Sarah does is she's so authentic in who she is that it really changed my vision of what I thought I wanted in a partner. You know, I always thought I wanted the goddessy kind of woman, you know, flowy and spiritual and all that. But Sarah, she's the real deal. She walks her talk. You know, she might not have all the jargon and all that, you know, all that stuff, that trendy kind of stuff that people do when they're promoting themselves physically, you know, to look like spirituality or whatever, but she was the actual, she does the work. And I think that's what was so very appealing about Sarah. And collectively, when we put those two energies together, the real practical things that are very applicable that work, and then my creativity and my freedom to just kind of go way out there, you know, she helped keep me grounded. When I had that experience I was telling you about a couple weeks back when I was going into that other realm type of thing. We were getting ready to do two sound healings right then and there. And she was able to keep me grounded enough to be present for those sound healings because I was out there. You know, I didn't know what was going to happen. But more than that, so from our connecting, she has just emerged immensely in her feminine nature, you know, her creative aspects. And who she already was, but we both have just helped each other emerge more wholly. So definitely, Sarah is a huge part. And when we do sound healing together, it's magic. A lot of people will say it's the way your energy, you guys, your energy together, the synergy of your energy together, there's something about it. And so people can feel it. It's palpable. And I feel that way also.
Oh, definitely. And me, you know, with my gifts and abilities, I feel her energy, you know, coming through you. It's so strong. Mm-hmm. And she has a beautiful, powerful energy. You're absolutely right. You two, you complement each other so perfectly. And I just love that we're seeing more and more of the divine masculine, divine feminine partnering up and working with energy to assist all of humanity. And you guys are really doing such a phenomenal job. That's why it's rare for me to reach out to people these days to ask them to come on and do a show. I'm really selective, but like, I just felt both of your energy. And I was just like, I felt called to reach out. And I'm like, this is what the collective out there needs. They need more healing. They need to be led into different ways to help them access who they are and to heal, to get there. That's the part that stops us from reaching all that we are, is everything that's unhealed. Those triggers stop us up and they don't allow us to access our higher selves. And it can be a challenge for a lot of people out there. So sometimes they need a little help doing that. And I love that you teach them the skills and assist them. So after they go through the processes with you, they could perhaps do that on their own.
Yes, no, completely. And I want to say that, you know, before I met Sarah, you know, I had a lot of self-doubt. I mean, there was a lot of things that I did not love about myself. I had a lot of shame, a lot of guilt. Sometimes I would use my powers in very selfish ways, you know, especially with women. I had a love-hate relationship with women completely. I wanted to love them, but I had selfish interests around sex. And when I met Sarah, the way that she loves me, the way that she allows me to be completely me. And I'm, you know, I've never, personally for me, I've never experienced that. You know, if I showed my jealous side, the women in my life would run because they don't like that. I mean, who does, right? But she, instead of running, she would own her own experience. And she understood that it was an expression of wounding. And, you know, for us, both of us, here's the basic ingredients of our relationship: self-accountability for our own experience and willingness to do the work. That's basically it. Other than that, you be you and I be me, you know, and let's do it together. So when she showed me that kind of love and that ability to hold that space through my wounding, through my most nasty things that I like to express, and she just loved me because she understood deeply that that isn't me. That was just my wounding. It changed my life, you know. It really, really changed everything for me. So I can really say that had she not been part of my life, I don't know that I would be doing this, what I'm doing right now, to be honest. That's how much that our union has nourished this journey. That's how important it was. It is.
I love that. And I was feeling that too. That's why I'm like, we got to make sure we put some time in here to speak about her, because she's such a huge part of, like you said, behind the scenes and in front, running front and center with you. So I'm glad that you got a chance to do that. And I think that it'll be beautiful for her to hear your expression of your feelings for her on the show as well.
Yeah.
I love it. Okay. So were there any other things that you want to add to this that we haven't just talked about? Because I want to make sure we're getting everything out that you want to include.
Yeah. No, I can't think of anything right this second.
Okay.
Thank you, Wendy. Yeah, thank you. We're both very service oriented, and that's our life, you know, service and really trying to help people become empowered. One thing you don't know is she's an eating disorder coach also.
Oh, wow.
So she worked she's really helping those girls or that population, you know, with that particular thing. And there's so much to it. Eating disorder, I had no idea. But Sarah is so good at helping people find themselves and becoming empowered. So it's just a joy. It's just a real joy. And I think both of us right now really love everything that we do. I mean, yes, we have our hearts just like everybody else, but overall, we love everything that we are involved with right now.
That's a beautiful place to be. That makes my heart smile hearing that.
Well, we had to work for it, you know? Like when COVID hit, you know, we were still working in the hospital on the front lines, and I was hating it, you know, not trusting the government, not trusting the hospital, all that stuff. And we were preparing for me to retire. And thank God, you know, her little Capricorn ways really paved the way for us. And, you know, I was able to get out. And, you know, before we got out, our son was in Montessori school too. So we had huge bills. We thought, how are we not, are we going to be able to afford this? Well, I can tell you, after all this, you know, we make more. Not that money's our thing, because it's absolutely not, but we make more money now than we did both working full-time at the hospital.
Oh, I love it. That's so wonderful.
And it's just like, yeah, the universe just said yes to you, yes to your dreams, yes to your passion. Go, sir. It's like, oh my God.
And that's so true, though, because when we are on the right journey, the doors can't open fast enough. Those speed bumps just kind of fall away and everything is smooth sailing. Not that it's going to be perfect every step of the way. There's going to always be some things that come up to kind of remind us of some things that we're not looking at. But overall, when we're doing the right thing, that's exactly the way it works. It's a perfect, perfect balance.
Yes, I hope that others can really find this for themselves. You know, I know that there's a lot of fear and you know, okay, but boy, I'm just rooting for everyone. Please find yourself. You know, you're going to love who you are. You're going to fall in love. And oh my God, that are in your heart, in your soul, that want to be shared. You are backed by divinity. You know, that's what I want to say to everyone.
Most definitely. I love that. What a beautiful message. And with that, I just want to tell you guys to take a look at Ross's website, check out his YouTube channel, his podcast. We'll get all the information, all the links for you on Lightwaves Radio. And then we'll also put them on the YouTube so that you guys can get in touch with him and or Sarah, both of them, and see if you can do a sound healing in Maui. And I think you guys even do it remote, don't you?
Well, we do some remote work, not so much sound healings, but I can do some remote work.
Wonderful. And, yeah. I love it. Perfect. Well, I just want to remind all of you out there, as always, to remember to make both your words and your actions come from your heart center. And Rasa, thank you so much for coming on here. You are amazing.
Thank you, Wendy. I really appreciate you as well. Thank you for all that you do, all that you share. Thank you so much.
You're very, very welcome. Have an amazing day, everyone.
Aloha.